Hello everyone, LeeJ2512. First things first, I'm in a different location. Ignore the jigsaw in the background. That's something my wife and I are doing. Shout out to any critters that like Critical Role. I have something to show you, which I got a little while ago. I hope everyone had a good New Year and good Christmas, holidays, things like that. Something to discuss with you first though, and it's not a sponsorship, don't worry, it's kind of the opposite. As of December, I am not with the YouTube program anymore. They dropped me for some reason. No warnings, no strikes, nothing. They said it was because I was using other people's content. The best thing I can think of is when the Wizarding World shared my video, but I didn't copyright that. And also the videos where I have scenes from the movies in it, like the Molly Weasley scene. I didn't copyright that either. I didn't put ads on that. I didn't claim it to be mine, nothing, so thoroughly confused. I tried to appeal it. The appeal was denied within 12 hours. No explanation. The appeal video never even got watched, so I explain everything in the community comments part that I did. I did a post for it about a month ago, but and I was quite taken aback because they wanted me to prove that it was me and not just me in my kitchen or dining room or bedroom making these videos. So it was a bit disheartening, really, a bit demoralizing. I was tempted to just to say, never mind then, I guess I'm done. But it was never about the money anyway. I never really got money. It was more about showing off what I had as a hobby. But it was more the way they treated me. 15 years of content doesn't seem to matter. Maybe the views were not great. Maybe I wasn't uploading as regularly as I should be. But that's always been my thing. I just kind of upload when I have something. So, which leads me to this. I was tempted to kind of think, maybe I'll leave it then, 15 years is plenty, but then I thought, wait, there's a new Harry Potter TV show coming out, maybe they've got replicas, so maybe they've got new stuff getting released, I might get that, we'll see. But anyway, I thought it was apt that this is a wand unboxing, sort of. It's from Noble Collection, and it is the Gilderoy Lockhart wand. This is the first time they've ever released this. The wand came out about, well, the movie came out 20 years ago, 22 years ago, almost, and they've never done a replica for it, ever. And this is the Gilderoy Lockhart wand. I'm so surprised they've never done it before, but now they have, over 20 years later. And you can see the difference. It's a massive wand, from Noble Collection, as usual. The wand, the box itself is really unique. You can lift this flap here to see the kind of design itself. And that's in it with a brief description as well. So I think it's magnetic as well. Very, very posh, I would say. So I'm looking forward to seeing. I've taken it out of the packaging. I haven't actually seen the wand itself yet. So it's very unique, or very poignant, I guess, to have this as my, last of my regular videos anyway. So it's a wand unboxing, which I did when I was 16. I'm now 31, so. But if there's any merch from the Harry Potter TV show coming out, I might do something like that. But here we are. Oh, it's the classic Ollivander box with the numbers on the side. Is the name on there? No. Okay. So here we are. Yep. Oh, the certificates, wow. I haven't seen one of these certificates in a while. Wow. I think they stopped doing them. Did they stop doing them for a while? Wow, I haven't seen these in a long time. They had these with these certificates with every single thing I bought when I was about 16. I think they stopped doing them. But anyway, here is the wand in its kind of velvet inside. And here we are. Here is a Gilderoy Lockhart's wand. And it's strange because I bought the book. I don't know if you guys have the book, The Wand Collection. It showcases every single wand that's kind of highlighted in the films. And this was in it. And I think I said it in the video I did for it. It'd be cool if they did a replica of Lockhart's wand. And they have. And it is like, it's almost like a short sword almost. It's a big wand. Like, did it say the measurements on the thing? Like, hang on, let me check to see if it says on this part. It must do. Yeah, 17 inches in length. That's ridiculous. And, yep. Velvet feel material and decorative ribbon. It's approximate 17 inches in length. I think this is the longest wand replica they've ever done. And I'm not surprised. It's got like a blossoming flower here. It just, you don't imagine Kenneth Branagh brandishing this, but he probably did. He must have if it's like a direct replica. That's pretty cool. I like that. I also saw on the box, where are we? It has collect them all. And I realized when I was looking at this, I have them all. Harry, Dumbledore, Hermione, Severus Snape, Voldemort, Sirius, Draco, Ron. I think I have all of these in the original boxes from a long time ago. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I just like how it's gone back to, I don't know, I say nostalgia because I did this a long time ago, and it seems like nostalgia to me because I filmed these kind of wand unboxings in my bedroom when I lived with my mum, and so much has happened since then. So it's great to kind of see things are kind of back to what it used to be, I guess. So I don't, what's this meant to represent? Is it like a flower or is it like a sword it's meant to represent? It's brandished like a short sword, honestly. It's quite big, but yeah. Let me know if you guys have this and what you thought. I was going to upload this way sooner. I was going to upload it when I got it, but then I got the news about the partner program and I was kind of a bit bummed out about that. So I thought, do I want to do a video? Do I want to leave it? So I'll put that away. It's cool. But going forward, I guess, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know if the Harry Potter TV show they're going to do is going to release a whole new wave of stuff. That might tempt me into doing more videos, but as it stands, I'm not sure. It's just kind of demoralizing, I guess, so we'll see. But I don't actually have anything I need to video anymore. I've held on to this for about a month, so yeah, let me know if you guys have it or any new cool stuff. I'm looking for new stuff. I've been going into charity shops and random stores and stuff to find cool things to film, and I've not been seeing a lot. I've been seeing new editions of the books, lots of editions of the books. I've been picking those up. I'm trying to get them all together for like a big video of all the different editions I've gotten from the past while. There's some really interesting things. Like, I live in Scotland and there's a few charity shops where the editions have been in Russian, Spanish. I've been collecting them all. And there's some where my friend let me know where there was one and it was gone by the time I got there. And it's just so strange. It's great to see. It's great to see different editions. And American editions as well. I don't have the full set of the old American editions. A subscriber sent me a long, long time ago the full set of one of the newer editions, and it was amazing. I've still got them. They're through like the opposite side of that wall in my other room. So that's it for me, I guess. I will hopefully see you guys soon. Hope you're doing well, and I'm looking forward to seeing that Harry Potter TV show. It looks like JK Rowling is executive producer, so could be accurate to the books, I hope. Anyway, here's hoping. Hope you guys are well. Take care. Bye bye.